Welcome back, guys, to Factorio Invasion of Earth. This is episode number 4, and it looks like we've got a power issue. Yes, we do have a power issue here, so I guess the first thing that we better do is craft up some boilers and some steam engines. So let's grab some more iron here. Get those up there on the power plant. I guess I was throwing miscellaneous parts on there here and there, but I wasn't really paying much attention to their placement because I thought that we were okay, but apparently we have overproduced. And oh wait a minute. Oh yeah. Well, yeah, of course we're out of coal at the moment, but I do have some coal that I can throw in here. Let's do this then. This should help. Get things started. A couple more of those, I guess. And looks like maybe three more. Three, one, two, four, six of those. 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, that should take care of the power problem for a little while longer. Just wait till these craft and the robots place them, and then we'll move on with whatever we were doing when we left off last time. Not sure what that was, but we'll run down there and check it out real quick. Pick back up on base building in just a few seconds. There we go. Alright, come on, robot, let's go. Alright, so back to it. Let's see here. I don't have any. We'll go ahead and redesign the coal mining operation, I think, since we're here and we need more on the power plant anyway. Let's just redesign this whole debacle here. Get rid of these lines. And let's see here. Well, okay, those are actually, you know what? We're gonna redesign this whole thing. So we'll take these all. You know what, we'll go this way with it. That should fix that. Okay, and then we'll take these guys and go this way. And block this. Okay, come on, there we go. We'll do it like this, and that should take care of, I guess I probably need to put those belts in between there so that it works properly. There we go. And then the power poles. And that should take care of the power for a little while anyway. Alright, and then we'll take care of the smelting in this operator. Oh, the water! What an annoyance. Okay, well, we'll work around it. This is an ongoing issue. And I can see that my anger management is going to be an issue too. I can't go there. Why can't I go there? Oh, there it is. I didn't see that little piece of water there. I can't mine any of that. That's all I got. Okay. Well, it is what it is, I guess. And so there. All right. So that just means that we'll have to. Okay. Find an alternate powering strategy like that. Okay, that's not connected. Oh, okay, there we go. Alright, it's all powered and we're back in business. Okay, as good as it gets for now, until we find another coal mine somewhere else on the map. Okay, so back to whatever it was that we were doing, which I think we were working towards military science. That sounds like the right thing. Let me throw this coal in this emergency chest up here since I have all this coal in my inventory. Wait, let's get rid of these. Nope, burner miners is what I meant to click on. Okay, and we'll get rid of that wood. Do I need that wood? No, I'm okay. I think I can deal with it. Okay. Throw this coal in the emergency chest, and you know what? While we're at it, I will. Okay, have an extra one. Okay, so I'm gonna take this, replace that with one of those, and throw that in there. So that will give us at least a few extra minutes of power after things go bad. So every second counts, right, when you have power issues. Alright, so back at the issue of military science. Yes, military science it is. And, oh, train building was our other priority. And let's see here, let's check on, we have military science capability already. And, oh, and technology wise, trains was our next, there we go, trains. We will add that to the list. Okay. Alright, so we have walls here. And we'll call that good. And then we'll add military science. Let's see, we need copper, iron, and steel, which we have right here. And stone bricks, which we have there, which is the walls already. And we need coal. Ah, yes, that's what we were doing was, oh, that's right. I keep forgetting we said that we were going to do military science in another town. And that's going to be up there in Canada. And we need to find a geographically appropriate name for that Canadian vicinity. What do they call it up there? They don't call it, It's a province, I believe they call it in Canada. So we need to find out what province that would be. I'll have to look that up. So we'll have to actually, it looks like we're going to have to bring coal in to Canada, which is going to be a bit of an issue. I guess we can do some kind of a track up through this region. We can pick up our iron and copper. Maybe we can do our military construct right in that region right there. So let me just look that up real quick. Canadian provinces. I'm just going to look it up on my phone here and see what name we can give that. And then I'll mark it on the map and then we can start working toward that. So Canada map with cities, there we go, thank you. And let's do an image search. Here we go. So we can, this one gives us what? So that would be Quebec, Ontario. No, that would be actually Nunavut. Nunavut? Looks like Nunavut is the province up there where I'm pointing. And let's see what town it would be. Nunavut. I think that's how that was spelled. Nunavut. None of it. Okay, and let me see what towns we have in none of it. Or. That one doesn't blow up big enough so that I can see anything. Here, let's try this one. Here we go. None of it. And we'll call it Baker Lakes. Yeah, that's one I can pronounce. The other ones are less Yeah, Baker Lakes is more like the about where the copper is. The other one I can't pronounce. I don't even know that I could. I don't even know that my English brain would let me even spell that, even though I'm looking at the spelling of it. So we're going to go with Baker Lake, none of it. Alright, so then let's go ahead and craft up some nameplates and run up there and mark that before I forget. And then we'll plan our base up there while we're waiting for the science. Let's see, nameplates are here, I believe. So we need Baker Lakes in the small font. Or no, actually, is that how I did it? How did I do it? Where's my nameplate? Oh, of course. Well, it's either way, right? I did it small and big. I think the town should be small, and the, is that the right way? Should it be the town is smaller, or the county, or the state or province should be small? I think, which way makes sense? See, New York is ambidextrous, right? It goes either way. So I guess we'll go, the town name large. Boy, there's not much room to put it here either, is there? Alright, we'll go right here. Oops. What'd I do? Here we go. Here. Baker Lakes. Okay, and that will go with the big one. And then we'll do none of it in the small one. N-U-N-A-V-U-T. None of it. And then if we... Oh, I don't need that D on there. None of it. And if we do it about here, I think. Let's see how centered that looks. Close enough. We don't need all those extra T's. I think it's just one T. None of it. Yeah, close enough to centered. And I'm not sure that that's the right color, but let's try it in the glass. Let's see, which one do I want to do? Let's try it in this one. Try none of it again. Where did I put those? There they are. N-U-N. A-V-U-T. Oh, I didn't capitalize before. Do I like it better capitalized? Let's see what it looks like. Okay, oh. Okay, we have to erase. N-A-N. Oh, I didn't spell it right either. Okay. Okay, guys, now you know what it's like to be inside my brain. It's an empty void. N-U-N-A-V-U-T. No, I didn't even... What the heck is going on? N-U-N-A-V-U-T. There we go. Stop pressing buttons. And... Unreal. Truly unreal. Ugh. Okay. T. T. There we go. Finally. Okay. You know that doesn't look bad with the copper and the iron. Baker Lakes, none of it. Canada. There we go. That is going to... Oh yeah, we're going to semi-plan this out. Military science thing out. Boy, it's going to be tough getting a train up through here. And that island... Oh my... Yeah, that's going to be fun. How am I even going to get there? I'm going to have to build a boat. I did install the cargo ships mod. Let's see how far we are away from a boat. Yeah, this is going to be interesting. And I guess while we're up here, we'll see if there are any biters up here. And this Okay, here's the deal, guys. If the biters are still absent by the end of this episode, then I will look into console commands to add biters to the game, because this is not the way it's supposed to be. I don't know. I have to think that it's something to do with this, the map settings that I actually have already experimented with regenerating this world. I considered completely regenerating the world, but every time I have done it, no matter what settings I have tried, I end up with the same problem with sparse res I either get sparse resources or I get like overabundant resources, which I don't like. And as far as enemies go, they're always just really distant. Even with expansion maxed out and everything, the enemies just are not appearing on the map the way that I think they should, especially for this playthrough. So I might have to go into map editor and add enemies, which I kind of hate to do because I'm not sure that I can restore the fog of war if I do that, and I really don't want to have an entire map exposed. Because I would have to go around and place enemies manually. So anyway, if you guys have an idea on that, if you have some experience with using console commands to add enemies to your world, or anything like that you think would be helpful, I would appreciate any suggestions you have in that regard, because honestly, I'm kind of at an impasse as far as, well, how far my brain will go in that direction. And man, there are just no biters anywhere in America or Canada that I have explored, all the way to Alaska. Yeah, we are clear, which is really not what I want to see. So let's see what Mexico looks like. There have to be biters down here somewhere. I don't understand the lack of biters at all. They should be. I just did a. I even did just the normal starting area. It wasn't even an expanded starting area, so they should be. I mean, more than just that one patch of biters that we had in the first episode. There should be biters here. Okay, the alternate timeline, I guess, could be that the biters had just moved into North America, but they had wiped out the rest of the world. We could say that's the deal for our storyline. Here's the coal that we need. Without water around it, that's excellent. And I'm not too unhappy with the ore generation. I'm glad that it's far away. That gives us the chance to have more trains and townships and or towns and cities or whatever. But come on, there's no biters on all of South America. I don't understand that at all. I'm not happy with this situation. So, I might just end the episode a little bit early, guys. And. Or maybe I'll just continue to run around and complain about it for a little while, and then I'll look into spawning enemies. And/or going into map editor and adding enemies to the map. Because, like I said already, I hate to repeat myself, but I mean, I am the only one talking, so I have to have a conversation with myself. But indirectly, you guys can converse with me in the comments if you would make your suggestions, because I'm gonna have to do something between episodes to add some excitement to this playthrough, because without biters, I don't see any reason to continue this. There's just no drama. We need drama. We need excitement, right? We need some excitement. Unless you just want to watch me build on a, basically a low resources creative mode world, which I don't think would be very fun for you guys. So let's add drama. All right. Yep. We will add drama. So then for the remainder of this few minutes that we have here in this episode, I think what we'll do, if I can get through these trees, I don't want to use my bots because they'll be spend the rest of the episode flying back and forth. Yeah, okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to I don't want to do it there. We're going to say that we will add biters in Mexico, and I'm going to do this just from memory and trying to remember what the map of Texas looks like. And Texas-Mexico border, and I think, if I remember my geography, I think we go kind of up like this. I think Texas does this kind of thing, and then, let's see, where is the Rio Grande? That would be the dividing line, and do I see a riverbed in this? I really don't, unless this is it. Oh, that must be it right there. Let's consider that to be the Rio Grande. Okay, so we'll follow that line. I think this line right here is going to be the Rio Grande. So we'll build a wall there, and we'll say, and this is not a political statement of any kind, guys. This is strictly, you know, strictly our playthrough rules here. We're going to say that the biters are, and I ran out of walls, but we're going to say that the biters, for the most part, are moving up from South America into North America, more specifically United States. So I'll put biters into Mexico and throughout South America at least, and just figure out where that. Okay, just going from memory, and I may or may not look at a map and kind of, I'm thinking that the border kind of is fairly straight across here in this region anyway. We'll call it that for now. We'll say that that is somewhat close to the Mexican border, and that, I think, I'm pretty sure that's the Rio Grande, so that maybe maybe that is the true border. May or may not look at a map. I don't know. I will decide on that. So then this wall can go away for now. Although this will be the divide. Well, that kind of was the divider of our eastern. Okay. I don't know what I'll do with that. We'll do with that later. That whole wall situation right there. And you know, I think that we will check our technology here. Yeah. We'll go ahead and queue up some more train technology. Oh yeah, and the boat. Yes, we need the boat because of the Canada situation. And we'll go ahead and get one of those. I think I'd rather have electricity than the car at this moment. All right, guys, that's where we're going to end it for this episode, I think. And in between episodes, I will add, yeah, that definitely looks like Texas there. I'm pretty sure that's a pretty good line on that border. Yeah, anyway, I will add biters to the map in some way. I will look for your suggestions in the meantime. It is Sunday, August 28th, that is the date. It's about 10:30 in the morning on Eastern Time. That's where I'm located. And I usually record either one or two episodes a day. So this episode will post tomorrow, which is Monday morning, 7 a.m. Eastern time. So between then and, well, that doesn't give you guys much time to respond, but if you can get a response in, say within the first 6 hours of this video posting, I will wait until, 2 o'clock in the afternoon. Yeah, that's about right. I could record around 3 o'clock tomorrow afternoon, which would be Monday afternoon. I'll plan on recording then. That'll give you guys some time to respond with ideas about the biters. So, until then, we will see you guys in the next episode. Hopefully, you guys will give me some ideas about how to deal with this biter situation. And if not, then tune in and see what I decide. Thanks for watching, guys, and bye-bye.